Good morning and welcome to Good Shepherd with our presider, Father Kent. Join us in prayer while listening to the gathering song, Blessed Be the Lord. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. So we welcome everyone as we come together here again in this 12th Sunday of Ordinary Time. Sorry for the technical difficulties at the beginning, running frantic. Our camera is acting up today. I don't know what's going on. So as we come together, brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You came to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God.
Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah said, "I hear the whisperings of many, terror on every side. Denounce, let us denounce him. All those who were my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps he will be trapped. Then we can prevail and take our vengeance on him. But the Lord is with me. Like a mighty champion, my persecutors will stumble. They will not triumph. In their failure, they will be put to utter shame, to lasting, unforgettable confusion. O Lord of hosts, you who test the just, who probe mind and heart, let me witness the vengeance you take on them. For to you, I have entrusted my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has rescued the life of the poor from the power of the wicked." The word of the Lord.
Seeking hearts will revive. A reading from the second letter, from a letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, through one man, sin entered the world, and through sin, death. And thus death came to all men, inasmuch as all sinned. For up to the time of the law, sin was in the world, though sin is not accounted when there is no law. But death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those who did not sin, after the pattern of the trespass of Adam, who is the type of the one who is to come. But the gift is not like the transgression. For if by the transgression of the one the many died, how much more did the grace of God and the gracious gift of the one man, Jesus Christ, overflow for the many. The word of the Lord.
Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the 12, "Fear no one. Nothing is concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. What I say to you in the darkness, speak in the light. What you hear whispered, proclaim on the housetops. And do not be afraid of those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body in Gehenna. Are not two sparrows sold for a small coin? Yet not one of them falls to the ground without your Father's knowledge. Even all the hairs of your head are counted. So do not be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. Everyone who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge before my Heavenly Father. But whoever denies me before others, I will deny before my Heavenly Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I would never let a lion come into my house. I'm a physical lion. I would never let a lion come and live with me. They're very cute, I suppose. They got the big manes. Their muscles are beautiful. You can see them just wrinkle and all that under their skin. They're incredible creatures, aren't they? But I know something else about lions. They have these sharp little objects inside their mouth. They're called teeth. And they will bite me. And I do not want to be bit by a lion. Everybody here agrees with me, right? Who here would let a lion come into their home? No? Nobody here would let a lion sleep with them at night? No? Then why do we let that happen with sin? Today in our gospel, Jesus says, "Do not be afraid of those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body in Gehenna." So often, we have such a care for our bodies, and we need to have care for our bodies. I love to run. I try to run frequently. Since it's gotten hot, it's kind of died off, I'll be honest. But I love to run. I try to eat healthy. I need to take care of this body. But if I need to take care of this body, even more so should I take care of my soul. Because this body is dust, and unto dust it shall become. This body will decay. But one thing will not decay in me, and that is my soul. So I should take utter care of it every step of the way. I should think, if I'm going to take care of my body like this, I should take care of my soul like this. If I'm going to wear a mask when I go out to Target, I should put a filter on my computer. That way my family is protected from the sins that are available there. If I'm going to be inoculated against the flu, I should inoculate my family by praying the rosary, by reading sacred scripture together. I know that sin is like a lion. It seems admirable sometimes. It seems desirable. But once you get close, what does it do? It goes like a roaring lion, prowling for someone to eat, as St. Peter says in his epistle. But there is a catch here. Don't worry. This is not a fire and brimstone homily. Because what does Christ say after this phrase? He says, "Do not be afraid, little sparrows." You see, I don't live in constant fear of lions. I know they're in the zoo. I know that I'm relatively safe from them. But I have a healthy fear of them. Because I know the moment I let myself get close, I'm in danger. And that's the same relationship we should have with sin. We shouldn't be afraid of it, but we should know it's dangerous. And we should know that God is taking care of us, even in the midst of this dangerous world in which we live. Each one of us are gems in the Father's eyes. Each one of us has each hair counted. We are his little sparrows. He will take care of us. But there's one thing God doesn't do. God never works against our freedom. And if we let the lion sleep with us at night, he doesn't deny us the choices of our freedom. Our responsibility is to be those gems in his eyes, to let him transform us. He says, "Do not be afraid, my little sparrows. I'm taking care of you. You need not be afraid. But do not forget the danger that sin poses us." So my friends in Jesus Christ, today we are on guard. If there's a way that you've let the lion of sin sleep into your house, even slightly, whether it's through media, conversations, what it may be, shoo it out. It don't need a place in your heart. Rather, let your Father take care of you, for you are little sparrows in his eyes. He loves you so dearly, and he wants you to shine like all the stars and one day join him in his eternal abode in heaven.
So on this day, happy Easter, everybody. Because today, Josh Gomer is going to be confirmed today that we were going to do this on the Easter Vigil, but you might recall we didn't have anything there. So, Josh, come on up, come on up, come on up forward. He's been taking classes all year long through the RCAA classes, and we have the opportunity to be witnesses now of his confirmation here on this Father's Day. So it's a great joy to celebrate the love of the Father and that our church continues to grow. So now I invite everyone to please stand, and we will begin with the renewal of our baptismal promises. And even though you have masks on, I encourage you to respond with a good hearty I do with these questions that I am asking you. So we have had the chance to be renewed here, and now let us profess our faith. And so please respond with a good hearty I do, especially you, Josh. Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. And so, Josh, of your own free will, you have asked to be received into the full communion of the Catholic Church. You have made your decision after careful thought, after the guidance of the Holy Spirit. And so I now invite you to profess this faith and to pronounce your own faith in the faith of Jesus Christ here through the Catholic Church. Josh, the Lord receives you into the Catholic Church. Congratulations. His loving kindness has led you here so that in the unity of the Holy Spirit, you may have full communion with us in the faith you have professed in the presence of his family. Now, Josh will receive confirmation and then First Holy Communion here at this time. So by your baptism, you have been born again in Christ and have become a member of Christ and his holy people. Now you are to share in the outpouring of the Holy Spirit among us, the Spirit sent by the Lord upon the apostles at Pentecost and given by them as their successors to the baptized. The promised strength of the Holy Spirit, which you are to receive, will make you more like Christ and help you to be a witness to his suffering, death, and resurrection. It will strengthen you to be active members of the church and to build up the body of Christ in faith and love. So, my dear friends, let us pray that to God our Father, that he will pour out the Holy Spirit on Josh to strengthen him with his gifts and anoint him to be more like Christ, the Son of God. All-powerful God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit, you freed your sons and daughters from sin and gave them new life. Send your Spirit upon him to be his helper and guide. Give him the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of right judgment and courage, the Spirit of knowledge and of reverence. Fill him with the Spirit of wonder and awe in your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Joshua Ambrose. And I'd like to mention also, we finally had our Chrism Mass. You are the very first person at our parish to receive this oil, so because this was freshly blessed just this past Friday. So congratulations, Joshua. Joshua Ambrose is the official name, right? Joshua Ambrose, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Well, Joshua will receive his first Holy Communion as well today. Yes. So let's congratulate and welcome Josh into our community of faith. Congratulations. I want to especially thank Father Ashmore, too, who has been working so hard along with Sarah Sheeran and Millie Hill, who have been working on the team for the RCA team. So it's a great blessing to see the fruits of their labor here with Josh. And so now, as we, as a community, let us offer our prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father. I printed up the petitions, but I don't know where I set them, so I got distracted by a million different things with the computer and everything, so hold on just a second, I apologize. Are your eyeballs pretty good?
No. Are yours better?
Do you want me to read them?
Yes, please. Okay.
So we pray that the church will fear no one, speak in the light, the light that God has revealed, and proclaim on the housetops what has been heard in whispers. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray that the world will find peace and be graced with civil leaders, blessed with wisdom, compassion, and humility, so that no one need fear those who would kill the body through violence or terrorism. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for the children that have been separated from their families by all kinds of means of violence and poverty. May they find compassion, security, and love as they seek renewal and hope. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray that all fathers will cherish their role in God's creation by guiding their children wisely, patiently, and lovingly as they grow to know the importance of faith in their lives. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray that as we grow weary, frustrated, and lonely in resisting the coronavirus, we may comfort knowing the parish family is with us in prayer. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray that those who are ill from the coronavirus and from all life-threatening disease may receive comfort, compassionate care, and the support, encouragement, and love of family and friends. Let us pray to the Lord. That our fathers who have died may be welcomed with joy by all the angels and saints into the everlasting life with the eternal Father. Let us pray to the Lord. And we pray for Mike Sievers, for whom this Mass is offered. Let us pray to the Lord. O God, we pray that in your abundant kindness you will answer us with your sure deliverance. We make our prayers through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that cleansed by its action we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, Lord, by your cross and resurrection. You have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Joseph our Bishop and James and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please listen and pray with us while proceeding to communion.
Oh. to soar like an eagle. Though I may journey far away from home, I know I'll never be alone. Where can
let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Well, we didn't make it into 45 minutes today. We had a couple other things, but it is a guideline, that is our goal, to be at about 45 minutes at this during this time. But I do want to make sure that we give a special blessing to all those that we call our fathers. So special blessing to all our fathers. And so I'll let you do the Good Shepherd thing or receive the Good Shepherd thing, whatever you want to do. The special blessing for all those that we call our fathers. So, Heavenly and most loving Father, we give you thanks for your love that you have shared with us and that we have experienced passed on through our earthly fathers. We ask that you would bless these men that we call our fathers, that they may be strengthened in their commitment and strengthened in their love, that they might more fully model your fatherly love in their lives. May the fullest blessing come down on all these fathers, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. If you are close by your father and in the same household, I guess, you might give him a hug or something. So, and I think that's everything. Oh, yes, migrants. Yes, yesterday was the day for the World Day for Refugees and Migrants, and we have a great way to assist in a very practical way with our Roots for Refugees program, the vegetables which are right outside. Please come and participate with them. Obviously, our churches are less full, so they can really use your business out there for those great vegetables and really to have a really tangible way of supporting the refugees and migrants. So, anything else? And also, congratulations, Josh, on your first Holy Communion. So that's great. So we welcome you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
As we go forth, let's listen to the song, How Can I Keep From Singing?
My life flows on in endless song, above earth's lamentation. I hear the clear, the far off hymn that hails a new creation. No storm can shake my inmost call, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since Christ is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing? Through all the tumult and the strife, I hear that music ringing. It finds an echo in my soul. How can I keep from singing? What though my joys and comfort die, the Lord my Savior liveth. What though the darkness gather round, songs in the night he'd given. No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since Christ
Your light will come, Jerusalem, for on you will dawn the glory of the Lord, and all nations will walk in your light. Alleluia, alleluia. Your light will come, Jerusalem, for on you will dawn the glory of the Lord, and all nations will walk in your light. Alleluia, alleluia. Christ is the light of the world. Peace surpassing all telling.
309, same book. 309. Next. Every age? Okay, yeah.
242.
Refuge in every age, O God. 683.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign.
Afraid, I go before.
welcome.